Hello everyone, today I'll be sharing a video of Phaco-emulsification with toric lens implantation in an old male patient who was on alpha 1 antagonist or Tamsulosin or Flomax. As we all know that Tamsulosin or Flomax is a selective alpha 1 blocker that works by relaxing bladder and prostatic smooth muscles. And it also works on iris, and it may cause the constriction of the iris dilator muscle. Alpha 1 inhibitor binds the post synaptic nerve endings of the iris dilator smooth muscles for a prolonged period, which may result in the poor pupillary dilatation. Preoperatively, always assess the patient first, do meticulous examination, check the dilatation, and always take the proper history, especially if you are considering an old male patient. If pupil is non-dilating, then you can start atropine or 1% eye drop 2-3 days prior to the surgery to get the better pupillary dilatation. If you are making incision, always try to make a crisp and small incision and place it slightly anterior to, in the cornea. Always try to make a big size of capsular excess. And always keep intracameral midriatics like epitrate and 1% lignocaine ready, and use the intracamerally in between of your surgery. Here you can see that fluctuating tendency of pupil. Selection of OVD is very important here, and always keep this high viscosity, cohesive, viscoelastic, and the combination of cohesive and dispersive both during your surgery. Like in this case, I completed my rexus, and you can see that as I started my phaco fragmentation, you can see the movements of iris. In this case, the nucleus was grade 4 plus, and I started with the vertical chop technique. And you can see that pupil has constricted. Always try to avoid the holding of iris. Once you catch the iris, the iris becomes more responsive, and it will start coming to phaco tip again and again. So whenever you are feeling unsafe, then you can stop the surgery, withdraw the phaco tip, and use midriatics, intracameral midriatic, to dilate the pupil, and you can again fill the chamber with high viscosity viscoelastic. So here again I used intracameral midriatic, and now I am filling the chamber with combination of dispersive and cohesive elastic, viscoelastic. And as you fill the viscoelastic, pupil dilates. Now hold the fragments and bring it at the level of iris plane for the safe phaco fragmentation, and by this you can complete your phaco fragmentation easily without creating any complications. In such cases, you can also keep pupillary expander devices ready, and if you feel that iris is more responsive and safe phaco fragmentation is not easy, then you can stop the surgery. You can even give anesthesia, and you can place the pupillary expander devices for safe phaco emulsification. Because there was no cortical matter, so I was ready for implantation. I implanted hydrophobic single piece implantation, that was toric implant, in the bag. And because pupil was not very well dilated, so sometimes it becomes difficult to get the location of exact placement of IV. During your irrigation, you can tuck the iris with the blunt instrument, and you can get an idea about the placement of the toric IV. Thorough anti-chamber cleanup and the visco removal behind the eyeball is recommended for the toric eyeball, because pupil was not very well dilated, so I avoided to go behind the eyeball and clean the antechamber thoroughly and maintain an average intraocular pressure to avoid the sudden decompression of antechamber. Thanks for watching.